Has the possibility of Godzilla's existence ever occurred to you? We're talking about a supersized reptile that's radioactive and breathes out atomic heat. As far as paleontology is concerned, things are about to get nuclear. Godzilla was the inspiration for the names of two prehistoric creatures found in New Mexico. The Gojirasaurus quayi, for being one of the largest theropods of its time period, and the Godzilla shark, or Draco.pris.tis Hoff.man.orum, for being the largest fossil of its kind, and for its large spikes along its back. Similar to our beloved atomic lizard, these creatures possessed very sharp teeth, like the 12 rows of piercing chompers on the Godzilla shark. Yikes! But which prehistoric beast may have served as inspiration for Godzilla's majestic form? And above all, could he have actually existed? A question many paleontologists like to participate in. Let's find out in this epic clash between fiction and science. Godzilla, the monster that stomps horror and thrill into the hearts of moviegoers, is a stunning creature. He stands at heights ranging from 50 meters to over 100 meters. His weight is estimated to be in the tens of thousands of metric tons. He possesses powerful abilities like the atomic breath, a devastating beam of nuclear energy, incredible regenerative capacities, allowing it to quickly recover, and a thick reptilian hide that provides protection. So with all these stunning characteristics, it's no surprise that his origins would rest not in a single species, but in a lethal mix of primeval predators. Godzilla's sheer size and might, reminiscent of one of the biggest land predators ever, the monstrous Tyrannosaurus Rex. Just like Rex, Godzilla sports a gigantic cranium holding rows of serrated, dagger-like fangs. These menacing chompers are great for tearing through skin and shattering bones, leaving even the largest prey susceptible. But Godzilla simply isn't about sheer might. His forward-facing eyes show excellent depth awareness and probably vision in color like most living reptiles. This perfect eyesight, comparable to that of theropods like the Carnotaurus, enables Godzilla to judge the distance to its prey and methodically target its weak places with deadly accuracy. The fear doesn't end there. Carnotaurus also features horns above its eyes, and although Godzilla lacks these bony decorations, his characteristic dorsal plates running along his back serve a similar function. These plates could give some sort of protection, but their main purpose might be intimidation, a visual demonstration of power that sends chills down the spines of even the most fearless animals. Godzilla's atomic breath, although not directly derived from any known ancient predator, could have origins in the scavenging behaviors of certain theropods. Imagine a Spindylosaurus with a sail on its back that held a bioluminescent organ capable of spouting a toxic gas, or perhaps a blinding flash of light to subdue animals. While Godzilla's flaming breath is significantly more devastating, the notion of a predator exploiting a distinctive physical characteristic for aggressive reasons matches that of these scavenging hunters. The picture of Godzilla pursuing enormous sauropods conjures a genuinely horrific scenario. Imagine a monster the size of a skyscraper stealthily approaching a ponderous Brachiosaurus, its acute eyes latching upon its prey. With a surge of speed, Godzilla closes the gap, his atomic breath briefly stunning the huge animal. Then, with a bone-crunching bite, delivered by his Tyrannosaurus-like teeth, the reign of fear is complete. But how precisely did Godzilla establish dominance over his ancient domain? The explanation lies in a unique combination of physical traits from several dinosaurs. His neck possesses immense strength, reminiscent of Ceratosaurus or Carnotaurus, suitable for overthrowing his victim. Combined with long and powerful arms with four fingers comparable to the nimble coelophysis, Godzilla boasted tremendous grappling ability. These arms may be utilized to keep prey still as he administers a lethal bite or to swat away lesser annoyances. Furthermore, his bipedalism with three-toed feet gave him stability on land and the ability to hold down prey while tearing their flesh, similar to the T-Rex. A long, strong tail resembling the Mosasaurus made him a capable swimmer. Imagine Godzilla churning through the underwater depths, his tail pushing him with enormous energy, enabling him to attack unsuspecting aquatic species. This tremendous armory, a terrible mix of land and marine predators, enables Godzilla to conquer any creature unlucky enough to cross his path. But Godzilla isn't just a monarch, he's a living, or rather stomping, moment of ancient strength. He symbolizes the raw strength of Tyrannosaurus Rex, the predatory cunning of Carnotaurus, and the agility of Coelophysis, the aquatic skills of Mosasaurus, and the sheer bulk of the biggest herbivores he would ever have preyed upon. This frightening mix produces a creature that is not merely a movie icon, but a horrifying reminder of the earth-shaking carnivores who once controlled the earth. Want to learn more about the genuine dinosaurs that dominated the Mesozoic era? Hit that subscribe button and descend into the prehistoric world with us. Godzilla's huge form, a combination of terrible qualities from many ancient predators, raises the question, where precisely does he sit on the evolutionary tree? Due to Godzilla's long arms and four-finger hands, experts suggest that he could belong to the primitive theropod family, the oldest progenitors of the same theropod we know and appreciate. For reasons still unknown, primitive theropods evolved with a reduction in finger numbers and a decrease in the length in their arms compared to their body size. Godzilla's lizard-like pelvis, like that of the magnificent sauropods, would also place him in the order of Saurischia. If these ideas hold true, then Godzilla may have shared the world alongside the Stegosaurus and Allosaurus throughout the Jurassic period. Now, while Godzilla shares many qualities with theropods, he bears several really unique attributes that distinguishes him from the rest. His most apparent characteristic, as previously mentioned, consists of the rows of enormous dorsal plates running down his back. These plates might have had numerous tasks akin to the plates on a Stegosaurus. They could have been for show, terrifying competitors, or recruiting mates, to control his body temperature through cooling and heating systems, or for simple defense, affording extra protection against assaults. Another noteworthy aspect is Godzilla's long, strong tail. Paleontologists think that tails of certain dinosaurs, and even some modern-day animals like camels, hold fat stores. Godzilla's tail might very well have functioned in a similar fashion, supplying him with an energy source during lengthy treks or times of scant food. Yet, there's one factor that actually differentiates Godzilla from the domain of dinosaurs. While dinosaurs were obviously strong beasts, none had the capability to breathe fire or energy blasts. The particular talent of atomic breath elevates Godzilla above a mere prehistoric predator, confirming his standing as a legendary entity with otherworldly qualities. While Godzilla is a compelling personification of primeval might, the rules of physics and biology make his presence in the world very implausible. His huge stature presents a big difficulty. A beast like Godzilla would need a heart of extraordinary power to flow blood properly across the whole body. We're talking about a 600 to 700 pound heart, bigger than any discovered. The limits of our circulatory system just couldn't sustain such a huge creature, especially one that walked on 2 feet. Therefore, another difficulty lies in movement. Godzilla's bipedalism, although unquestionably spectacular, wouldn't be conceivable for a beast of his proportions. The massive strain imposed on his legs would make walking exceedingly difficult, if not impossible. Massive beasts like the Titanosaurus acquired a quadrupedal posture for a reason. It distributes their weight more evenly and gives them more stability. Godzilla's food intake would be tremendous. To maintain his energy demands, he would need to ingest an amazing quantity of food every single day. Finding enough prey to fulfill his hunger would be a huge challenge, perhaps destabilizing the whole ecology. Finally, let's not forget about reproduction. Imagine the logistical headache of Godzilla finding a partner. Never mind the hurdles of courting and mating itself. The huge size differential between Godzilla and any possible partner would make successful reproduction exceedingly unlikely. Although Godzilla is an exciting character, the constraints of science and the natural world make his existence exceedingly implausible. However, this doesn't undermine his standing as a pop culture legend. Godzilla provides a reminder of the awe-inspiring strength and mystery that ancient monsters had, even if they weren't nearly as ridiculous as our beloved radioactive lizard. He defies the limitations of what a dinosaur may be, and while scientific correctness may not be his forte, Godzilla exemplifies the notion of the ultimate apex predator. he permits us to explore the what-if situations, the possibilities that lie just outside the confines of the actual world. So what do you think? Could Godzilla ever exist? Check out our other videos that investigate the true science behind your favorite dinosaurs.